Hello everybody, what is going on? It is Jimmy here, back with another video. And I know I just did a Pokemon video like yesterday, and the day before that I did another one, but you know what, there's just so much news that's been coming out. Yesterday was what I would like to see in a Diamond and Pearl remake, and today I want to talk about some stuff that's actually going to happen. Yesterday's video is completely probable, and I know you guys do enjoy the Pokemon videos. They always seem to do better in terms of my viewing, especially yesterday's got almost 30 views within a 24-hour period, which for me is actually really, really high. So today we have some leaks to tell you guys about the Crown Tundra, which is coming out in less than 2 days. If, you know, you didn't know that, I don't know what to say, because it is coming out in less than 2 days. I'm so excited to play it. I may actually give you guys a full review of it. I don't know. It just depends on how quickly I beat it. I keep promising reviews, but I have no time to beat these games. Just this week's been very, very busy, and I'll be back to doing stuff like that later on, but right now I just can't do it for you guys. So if I do get a review out, it'll probably be next week or the week after, because I do need probably a couple weeks to get my life in order, do all that stuff so that I can come back. That's kind of why I started to post one time a day on YouTube, so that I could get everything back in order like it used to be, guys. And then once all that's in shape again, I will probably return to the 2-video-a-day format. But until further notice, I only really have time to do 1 video a day, and that's just kind of how my life's going to be right now at the moment. So let's get on to these leaks. If you don't want to know spoilers for the Crown Tundra, I advise you not to watch this video. I will not take it personal. Just click out of the video and don't watch it, because obviously if you don't want it ruined for you, then that's fine. I don't blame you. Somebody like me who, you know, I live for stuff like this, I need to know right now. And I know there's some of you guys who are out there just like that. And honestly, I can't blame you guys. I'm one of you guys. I want to know the news right now. So I'm going to tell you the news right now. If this video does get taken down, I will have a backup video posted today, because I do want to keep one video on the channel every day. So if this video gets nerfed by Nintendo, then I guess I will have to post something else. I do have another video ready. I had it planned to come out tomorrow, but I guess I'll release it today if this video gets taken down, but I really hope it doesn't. So let's get into this. Centro Pokemon Leaks on Twitter is the man or woman. I don't know who's in charge of the account, but whoever they are gods. And I just want to say that they're always right about stuff like this. So spoilers, here we go. You can choose a horse similar to how you choose Urshifu for the towers. Ultra Beasts are catchable in the post game. Legendaries are unlocked as soon as you can access Dynamax Adventures. Main story is around 4 hours. So the main story is only 4 hours. I was kind of depressed about this. I figured it would be more like 8 to 10, because the fact that the first part of it was only about 3-4 hours. And you know, if you were trying to fly through, you could get through it in like 2.5-3 hours. Me, I got through it in about 6, because I take my time with stuff. So this is probably going to take me 6 to 8 hours to complete this. And you know, honestly, that's not too long. I wish it was a little longer, but whatever. So here is the Dex entries here. So number 894, Regieleki. Number 895, Regidrago. Number 896, Ice Horse. Number 897, Ghost Horse. Number 898, Calyrex. And 2 alternative forms riding each horse. So apparently they're putting those all in the same Dex entry. Basically, that's it when it comes to news. I will post the picture. There is a picture showing every single shiny Pokemon and non-shiny version of them. And the shiny versions of the birds are literally basically the regular forms of them. They look, to my knowledge, identical. I'm trying to see any differences here. I think they're identical. Regieleki is just more electricity. Regidrago or Draco, however you say that, is the he's a lighter shade overall, and he's got some lighter parts to him. The white horse, it does look very ice. I think it will probably be an ice type. Shiny, it is a darker purple ice. Now the other two horses, the black horse is, well, I guess it's one horse. It is purple hair, and then the shiny is the red hair. And Calyrex just gets a little bit of a more yellowy tone, and then the shiny Calyrex just gets a yellower tone on the same one, and the shiny Calyrex on top of the horse that's black, and that was the white one before what I said, but this one that's the shiny one that's black just gets that more yellowy color in him too. So they said that they will be taking down these images, so I will make sure to provide them in the video as a staple, so if they take them down, then we don't have to worry about it. They can always be up here unless, you know, Nintendo takes down this video, which is a very much so possibility, so I will do my best to kind of mess with it so that Nintendo doesn't take it down. So I'm sorry for that if, you know, you were wondering why it looks so weird. I don't know what to say. I had to, you know, edit it up a little bit here. But I'll try to preserve all the colors and try to preserve everything. I'll just add some stuff around it to try to make it to where Nintendo's stuff doesn't really get in the way. So anyways, now I want to tell you guys my main thoughts on this. So I'm very excited for this. The Crown Tundra does look a lot better than the Isle of Armor did. And I did enjoy the Isle of Armor a little bit. I'm not going to say I loved it, but I did not hate it whatsoever. I thought it was pretty good. And I thought it was a step in the right direction compared to the base game. With that being said, said, I expect a lot out of this Crown Tundra, and I hope we learn a lot about the characters and different things. I'm looking forward to this thing, and I hope that it does turn out to be as good as it actually looks to be. Fusion Pokemon is something we don't see a lot. Kind of started with Black and White, Black 2, White 2. And honestly, though I do like seeing more of them, I can't help but think that the main Fusion Pokemon will always be Kyurem and Reshiram and Zekrom. I'm sorry. That's what I think. So that's kind of my thoughts on this whole thing. If you have enjoyed this video, don't forget to drop me a like, comment, or subscribe. Tell me down below, are you excited about this? What do you plan on doing when you play it? And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys want to hear more Nintendo news, more Pokemon news, more Xbox Series X news, more PS5 news, more PC news, more overall gaming news, don't forget to drop that subscribe button. Drop it down to where it goes from red to gray. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I know I said this like three times in this video, but Jimmy out of here.